This experiment is going to use the nanoVNA to look at the characteristics of common mode chokes that are homemade. So we're going to look at two common mode chokes. This one right here is from a toroid with Palomar Engineers, and it's RG58 cable, 17 turns, you count them on the inside, and PL259 connectors at the end. So if we remember, common mode currents travel on the outside of the coax. So we're going to be looking at the sheath of these toroids here, or these filters. This one right here is also using Palomar Engineers toroid, but it's only got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 turns on the inside. So we're going to characterize them both using the nanoVNA. And the nanoVNA is connected via USB port here to the laptop. So let's go ahead and run nanoVNASaver over there and start it up. So first of all, we scan the nanoVNASaver, and then once we have the correct port selected, we connect to device, and we get something. So now we notice that the sweep control has a start and a stop frequency of 3 to 30 megahertz. So we go over here to sweep settings, and we change that to continuous sweep. Okay. Notice in the display that we're looking at the S21 gain. This is where I set this up here on the display. And we go down here, and you see S21 gain. Now, the nanoVNA itself is going to show that information as S21 log mag 10 dB, but it's essentially the same one. Okay, so right, so now we say sweep and we start taking data. Now notice one thing, the nanoVNA doesn't update, but the screen on the nanoVNASaver does. It's because the nanoVNASaver software has taken over control of this device. Going back over here to our experimental setup, we have the nanoVNA, and it's got this SMA to BNC crossover here and here for port 1, which is S11, and for port 2, which is S21. And the other thing that you'll notice is I've got these little alligator clips. Now, I didn't use the standard alligator clip connections, that this is a small one, because I didn't want the cable to act like an antenna. So I made my lead particularly small. But if you look in here, you can see right there and right there that we're going to the measure point of the BNC connector. All right, so let's give it a shot. Well, before we do that, are we actually measuring what we think we're measuring? Well, let's look at the nanoVNASaver. And we see there that the x-axis, which goes from 3 megahertz to 30 megahertz, shows a little bit of a ramp-up curve, the yellow curve. And we look in the y-axis that the S21 gain in decibels goes from minus 70 to minus 40. Remember, the gain in decibels, it shows attenuation. So we want it to go negative to show that it's really attenuating. So in this case, we are attenuating to minus 65 dB on the 3 megahertz extreme, and about minus 46 dB on the 30 megahertz extreme. Well, that's exactly what we would expect because we have an open circuit. So the attenuation is quite large. And that now what we can do is we can short this out and check out the other extreme of this measurement. See if that'll stay. There we are. And we see there now that the S21 gain is going from 0 all the way to minus 0.7 when it goes from 3 megahertz to 30 megahertz. So it's fairly continuous right there across the range of interest. So this 2-point check seems to be doing pretty good before we start measuring. One other thing to notice is that in the nanoVNA, we have this fellow right here providing a short between the sheath of S11 and the sheath of S21. Just to go ahead and make sure that we don't have any stray charges or anything like that. Now, the other thing is to avoid RF stray charges, we could have encased this entire measuring point, as some people do, by putting it in a metal box. But we didn't, we did it this way. And okay, so one last thing is that there is a QSO today from 2021. There's a lecture or presentation that the information will be in the description, but it shows that, or it mentions that a good rule of thumb for good common mode rejection is to have an S21 gain of minus 25 or lower. In other words, minus 25, and from there on down, minus 30, minus 40, whatever. That means we have a good attenuation. So with that, let's go ahead and put our first candidate to the test, see what it looks like. And again, what we're doing here, notice, is we're measuring the outside, because that's the impedance attenuation, or the attenuation of the common mode currents we want, is on the outside of this. So we make sure we're not shorting in the middle, there or there. This is connected, everything is good. Now, this is the curve that we're getting on the NanoVNASaver. The NanoVNASaver now is showing that the curve is essentially like a logarithmic curve, but not quite. It reaches a maximum around here, around 25 meg. And then it drops, and by the way, that one is, that maximum is at minus 15 dB. Okay, and then the other extreme is minus 20, that's the best it can do, at 3 megahertz. So does this meet the criteria for a good common mode rejection filter? No, because remember, we said that that QSO today presentation mentioned it has to be minus 25 or lower. So in this case, minus 14, nope, not quite minus 25. Minus 20, nope, not quite minus 25. So we're not even getting to lower, we're not even getting to minus 25. So this fellow right here, we're gonna put him off to the side. Maybe at a future project, we'll get a longer coax, maybe an RG316, and wind it a few more times. Let's put him off to the side. Now, this guy right here, like we said, has got 17 turns. Let's give him a shot. This is gonna be a little bit of a challenge. Make sure we have this guy connected there and there. And now it's going to be a bit of a challenge because, yeah, this is, see if we can reach all the way across to this side to measure. Okay, there. Okay, it's connected. Okay, so now what do we see on the NanoVNASaver? First of all, the auto scale on the y-axis has gone from minus 40 dB to minus 30. This entire range is below minus 25. So right away we're saying that this filter right here, this common mode rejection filter, is working, or is expected to work pretty well over the region of interest. Now we can delve more into it and say, okay, the maximum right there is at minus 33.5, right around 25 megahertz. And the best it can do, it's actually very respectable, minus 37.5 or thereabouts, at around the 40 meter band, around 7 megahertz. So this filter is actually working fairly well. Again, notice that we're measuring the outside sheath because the common mode currents travel on the outside of the coax. So hopefully that was useful. And again, we're just using the NanoVNA on the port that we normally don't use, which is S21. Typically, we just restrict ourselves to the S11 port to measure the SWR and things, but we always knew that the NanoVNA could measure filters, and we may not think of a choke as a, or common mode choke as a filter, but that's exactly what it is. It provides an impedance over a frequency range. Hopefully that was useful.